Hello, it's Sylvain from Parseur, and today we are going to parse PDFs with a new engine. This engine is made to extract data from PDF documents such as invoices or receipts. So I'm going to start by uploading a couple PDF invoices. But first, I'm going to create a new mailbox for my providers. So provider invoices. It's going to parse just emails and documents. In our demo, it's going to be only documents because we're going to upload them and not send them by emails. So here we go. Let me upload two invoices from our coffee supplier. There we go. So they're uploaded. Two PDF docs. Let's take a look at it. So this is the first one. We see an invoice with a few info, a table with the items, subtotal and grand total. If we look at the other one, we see that it's a bit longer. It's spans over two pages, and there is an additional delivery field here. Let's create a template. It's more visual than the usual PDF document parsing because it's not converted to text. However, if you prefer the text version of the engine, you can also use it. In parallel, you can mix and match text and OCR templates so they work together. So I'm going to call this template coffee invoice because it's going to be used to process invoices from our coffee supplier. Here we go. So now I'm going to extract this piece of data here. This is the supplier name. Just as usual, I create a new field. I call it supplier name, and here I see that it's a mandatory field, so I leave it like this. I'm not going to talk about this for now, we see it later. One more thing here, I suggest that you make the field box very wide to be sure to catch all of the supplier name in case it's a bit larger in another invoice. Okay, so we have our first field. It's always going to extract data at this position here in the document. We are going to call it an absolute field. Right now, we are going to see how to create a relative field, which means it's a field that could be positioned in a different place in the document. And so to help the engine know where the field is going to be positioned, we are going to use a label. So let me show you how to do that. For example, with the subtotal here, we see that because the table can be more or less long, so it's going to shift its position from the top to the bottom of the document and across pages also potentially. We are going to define a label here on subtotal. This is going to be used as a landmark in the document. The label is looked up inside of the document by its text content. We save the label. It's automatically named after the content of the label. And now I'm going to create the field that I will attach to the label. So this is the actual field. And I'm going to call it subtotal. And I'm going to attach it to the subtotal label. So the subtotal field, just as the supplier name field, they are required fields. So if they don't match anything inside of the document, the template matching is going to fail and is going to try another template, the next one in the list. Here we saw that delivery is not always present in all documents. Sometimes it's there, sometimes it's not there. So I'm going to create an optional field and show you how they work. So it's the same concept as we used before. We are going to create a new label, but this time we are going to make it optional. So we are going to uncheck the label presence is required here. We're going to save it, and we are going to create a delivery field. I'm going to call it delivery fee. And we are going to attach it to the delivery. As we see here, delivery label is optional, so we need to make this field optional, of course. And now we have our new optional field. Great, let's see how that works. Let's create the template and process both documents. So both documents are processed successfully. We can see that here we have supplier name and subtotal. And on the other one, we have supplier name, subtotal, which is different, and the delivery fee, which appears only on one of the documents. Okay, so now that we saw how the fields and the labels and optional fields work, we're going to move on to the table. So let's open the template back again. And now we are going to define the table. As we see, the table can be quite long and can vary in size. So we need to define two labels, one for the start of the table and one for the end of the table. So first, we're going to find a piece of text that is always the same and that will mark the beginning of the table. So here we take the description. Even if we are going to use this as the column name, it works fine, so we can use it also as a label. Yes, it's required. And now we're ready to create the table. So we are going to take also the column name inside of it. I'm going to go all the way down to the bottom of the table. We are going to create a new table field and we are going to call it items. It's a required field and we want it to start at description and we want it to end at subtotal. We also include the table headers in the selection. And now we're going to create the columns. So be careful when you create the columns. Just click inside of the table rectangle and make sure that the item text can overflow a little bit and still stay in the right column. So here is my first columns, quantity, the unit price, and the total price. As you can see, the column labels are taken directly from the table itself. Here I want to rename QTY to quantity, so I'm going to do it like this. I'll create the new column, which is actually a rename. And here we go. Here we see that we are including the footer inside of the table. So we see that here it's extracted as part of the data, and we don't want that. So we are going to define the footer margin like this to exclude the footer data from the table. And the same for the header. We are going to set a little margin so that we don't extract data that is irrelevant. Right, let's save and update the template. As usual, you need to reprocess the document to see the new data. Here we see that the table is extracted completely. And we don't extract the footer, so that's exactly what we wanted. However, let's take a look at the other document. We see that the table looks very different. So let's reprocess to get the data from it. Okay, we see that the table is extracted as 4 lines, but we actually see that there are only 2 lines. So this is where we want to use our table merging feature. So let me show you how it works. Let's open the template. And let's edit the items table. And here you have the row merge options. And we want to use to merge on quantity and to align on top. But this is not very practical to see how this feature works. We would really like to see it applied to the first document with a small table, right? So what we are going to do is we are going to add the new document as a sample so that we can work with it in the template editor. So we are going to go back to the document. Okay, we are not going to save the template right now. We are going to go back to the first table. And here we are going to use add sample to template. So we add this document to the template. And as you can see, the table box automatically adjusts to the size of the new table, which is smaller. So let's edit the item table again. And here we see that the rows doesn't align. So let's merge the rows according to the quantity column. We could also use the unit price or the total price. What matters here is that the column that is containing data will be used to trigger the merging of the columns together. Okay, it's going to be clear when I show you how it works. So we use the quantity column to merge rows. And we decide that the quantity is going to be aligned on the top. So it automatically merges all the rows together as we want. Save it. Update the template. Go back to the first document and reprocess. And we see that the table items are properly aligned and defined. There we go. I hope you enjoyed this presentation of our OCR parsing engine and you are ready to parse all your PDF documents with it. Post your feedback by email at support@parseur.com by commenting under this video or through the live chat inside the Parseur app. Happy parsering!